It's a proud and an emotional moment today because this is the 20th anniversary of FRAMES. Two decades ago when some visionaries decided to create this platform for media and entertainment community, neither the Indian media nor FRAMES was what it is today. These 20 years have been a spectacular roller coaster ride for all of us. I have been part of this journey for most of this part, and it makes me really feel sentimental and proud that I have played a small role in this. From being a very small and somewhat fragile media and entertainment industry 20 years ago, today it is a source of global ambition and envy, and so is FICCI FRAMES. FRAMES was envisioned to be a platform where the media and entertainment community could get together to discuss its issues. Given the scale at which it is today, it would do its visionary founders very, very proud. Over time, FRAMES has become the most meaningful platform for media and entertainment community, not just in India, but in this part of the world. Attempts to clone it can at best be described as unrealized ambitions. My heartiest congratulations to FICCI and Dean FRAMES, led by Nina Jaisani, who have been relentless in their passion and their commitment. Team FRAMES, without you, it would not have been possible. On behalf of the entire media and entertainment community, I salute them all. The transformation in the media and entertainment industry in India in the last 20 years has been mind-boggling, to say the least. It is one of the major media markets in the world now. It is also one of the most exciting media markets anywhere in the world, with every major global company trying to give shape to its ambitions in India, and with the Indian company challenging them equally vigorously. It's emerged as the world's biggest media battleground. So what does the journey ahead look like for us? We will hear the views of our accomplished experts and practitioners over the next 3 days, so I don't need to give you my own to it. But in my humble opinion, the great Indian media and entertainment story has just begun. We are standing at an amazing inflection point. We can either sit on our laurels, or we can use the winds of change to fill our sails and embark on an even more exciting and glorious journey. We need to recognize the power of this creative sector in helping realize the national aspirations. Indian media and entertainment industry is ready to contribute more actively and more substantially than probably any other sector of the economy to the dream of creating jobs, assets, and wealth that this country nourishes. What's more is that we are also in a position to be the flag bearers of brand India, not all over the world. We are already seeing the innovations that are taking place in this country, in the world of sports, in digital, in entertainment. Indian movies are winning new accolades all over the world, where Indian creativity is being talked about globally and attracting the interest of one and all. However, we need to make sure that our policies are aligned to accelerate creativity and growth. We should remove the bottlenecks and the roadblocks. Wherever we find these tracks, we should be able to help to step in and align them while making sure that the larger social interest is always kept front and center. At the same time, we also need to make sure that in the name of bogus or phony social or national interest, we do not waste the potential of this industry. That would not just be a disappointment, but also very unfair to the world of good that this industry is ready to do to the crores of people in this country who can benefit directly and indirectly from it. I shall stop dwelling further on this subject because that is what you're going to hear from our illustrious speakers over the next few days. Before finishing, I would just like to highlight that this has been a very successful year for FICCI Media and Entertainment Committee. The committee has been instrumental in bringing about some key reforms for the industry, including a revision in the GST slab that was a long-pending demand for the entertainment sector, and tabling of the anti-camcording provisions under the Cinematograph Act. I'm sure it will soon become law. It marks a very satisfying year for me as the chairman of the committee, and I would like to congratulate all those who have been involved in making this happen.